Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. What up guys, today is this week's end reset. Like always, if you guys are looking for anything specific, check out the description below, there's going to be timestamps over there, so finding things is going to be much easier. But anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video or find it helpful, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe for more videos, and let's get right into this. Starting off first, you guys want to check out the special blueprint vendor down in the terminal, and the first thing I'd recommend checking out is this MG5 blueprint. If you guys are looking for a good LMG, this weapon, in my opinion, is the best in its category, so if you are looking for a Lone Star build, or if you just want to make a build with a LMG, definitely pick up this blueprint. Moving down, you want to check out this 5.52 Hollow Sight. If you guys are doing a AR kind of critical hit chance build for PvP or PvE, and you are in need of a little bit more critical hit chance so you can do a bit more damage, this scope is really, really useful. You can potentially get a god roll if you get lucky, so once again, if you are missing this, check out this vendor. Lastly, you guys want to check out this Omega Rifle Suppressor Blueprint, and if you guys are looking for a headshot damage scope for your sniper rifles or ARs, this is the right thing for you. Once again, you can purchase this, craft yourself a God Roll 1, and just be set. So, if you're looking for any of those items, definitely check out this vendor in the base operations. Up next, we're stopping by the Special Equipment Vendor, and the first thing you guys want to look at is this Liberator. Now what it comes with is 18% enemy armor damage, 257 gear score, and for the talents it has talented, destructive, and competent. This weapon in my opinion is for PvE since it does have destructive and already has competent as well for the damage in the free slot, which is very very useful. The only thing you really have to do is get predatory, get something like ferocious, or you can get something like unforgiving or even vicious or deadly for a little bit more damage as the first talent. So if you're looking for a decent M4, this Liberator is for you. Now lastly, you guys want to check out this mask. This is actually a pretty good tenacious mask, and what it comes with is 1268 stamina, 3.50% critical hit chance, and 13% increased skill XP. Now the only thing you really have to do with this one is reroll the minor attribute. I would try to get something like damage fleet or something like burn resistance on this mask, because I mean it already comes with a lot of stamina, it already comes with critical hit chance, and that's pretty much what you want on this thing if you are using a tenacious mask. The one thing is, again, reroll the minor attribute and probably optimize this once or twice and you will be set. Next up, we're visiting the Dark Zone Gear Vendor, still at the base operations, and the first thing you guys want to look at are these Savage Gloves. Now what they come with is 1235 electronics, 10% assault rifle damage, 8% skill haste, and 16% critical hit damage. These gloves, in my opinion, are very, very good for a maybe kind of PvE build or kind of a tactician, kind of skill power, skill haste orientated build. They already have AR damage, they already have critical hit damage, they already have skill haste, and that's pretty much what you want on that kind of build. And it already comes with electronics, but you could obviously reroll this to stamina or firearms depending on your build. Just overall, these are pretty good. So if you are missing them for a specific build, check them out. Now the final thing you guys want to check out is actually this mod. This is actually a 264 stamina and 2910 skill power mod. This one's pretty good. Once again, it is not maxed out, but if you are going for a specific kind of hybrid build between stamina and skill power, this mod is for you. So again, it is located in the DZ Vendor in the base operations. The special blueprint vendor at Camp Clinton is next on my list, and the first thing you guys want to check out is this Pro Red Outside blueprint. This, in my opinion, is very, very good if you're going for a damage build and you need a bit more critical hit damage on your ARs, your SMGs, your LMGs, pretty much whatever you can put this on. They are very good. And again, with the blueprints, you can craft a lot of them and get yourself potentially a god roll. Now, the final thing you guys want to check out is this small grip. And this, once again, is a small grip that comes with critical hit damage. So if you're missing one, if you are new to the game, if you're coming back, you want to finish up your shields before Division 2. And you want, you know, a decent grip, this blueprint is here for you again. So definitely check out this vendor. It is worth picking those things up. Now moving over to the special equipment vendor, the first thing you guys want to check out is actually this Super 90. Now what it comes with is 330% stagger, 273 gear score, and for the talents it has predatory, vicious, and ferocious. This once again is a pretty good PvE weapon. It already has ferocious for the damage, it already has vicious as well, for obviously the damage and extra critical hit chance. And then you also have predatory, which is actually really, really good for PvE in my opinion, because it's always going to heal you, it's always going to give you that extra kind of health boost, and for PvE that's always something you kind of want. Now obviously you can reroll this into maybe deadly, pair that up with vicious, maybe even responsive, maybe destructive if you want, Or if you want to use this for PvP, you can get rid of ferocious, get responsive, get competent, deadly, anything like that will work on this weapon. So again, this is a really nice buy if you guys are interested. Going all the way down to the gloves, you guys want to check out these Savage gloves once again. These are pretty good. They're not as good as the other ones in my opinion, but these are very, very good as well. So they come with 1147 electronics, 6% critical hit chance, 16% critical hit damage, and 10% SMG damage. You're pretty much set with these gloves for the major attributes. You have all the damage kind of rolls, and you also have SMG damage. The only thing you really have to do is get rid of the electronics, go into firearms or stamina, or just reroll the electronics and get it a little bit higher because it is pretty low. And then the final thing you guys want to check out is actually this C79 scope. Now this one's really, really good for MDR builds or kind of dead eye builds. If you guys want to use a scope, but you don't want to zoom in like, you know, a crazy distance, the C79 scopes are really good. They zoom in a tiny amount and they activate, the dead eye bonus. So what it comes with is 18% critical hit damage, 2.50% stability, and 4.50% optimum range. You have the stability, you have the optimum range, and that's pretty much the kind of combination you want for a Deadeye build. You also have a really high critical hit damage roll, and once again, that's pretty much what you want on the scope. So if you're interested in this one, check out this vendor and buy this thing 100%. If you guys are looking for a really nice damage elite mod, you want to check out the Camp Hudson Gear Vendor. What he's actually selling is a pretty nice 3% damage elite mod with 202 electronics. Now, unfortunately, it is with electronics and it is a 3% roll, but if you're making a kind of sticky bomb seeker mine build for PvE, these mods are perfect for that. So again, this is located at the Gear Vendor at Camp Hudson. Up next, you guys want to check out the Madison Stan Safe House, and he's actually selling a pretty good stamina mod. This one actually comes with 265 stamina and 1% critical hit chance. If you're going for a kind of hybrid build again with a little bit of stamina and you want a bit more critical hit chance on that build, this mod is pretty good. It's 2 points away from being a god roll with the stamina. So again, if you're looking for this one, this is definitely a worth buy. Getting straight into the DZ, the first person you guys want to stop by is the East 46 Shoe Checkpoint. And what he's actually selling is a pretty nice small grip. What it comes with is 18% critical hit damage, 2% accuracy, and 4.50% optimal range. If you guys don't want to buy the blueprint, you just want to buy this kind of grip itself. It's being sold here, so it's not the best. You could obviously get higher critical hit damage. You could obviously get like stability instead of accuracy. But, you know, this one's for sale. So if you don't want to go through the troubles of buying the blueprint and re-rolling this, just buy this one. It's pretty good as well. A couple spots down, you guys want to stop by the East 43 checkpoint still in the Dark Zone. And the first thing you guys want to check out is this prototype firearms mod. What it comes with is 261 firearms and 2.50% EDR. Now, if you guys are making a final measures build and you want to go up in kind of your EDR category, or if you are using a nomad build, you want to be a bit more resistant towards nades and bleed, this mod is pretty good. It is missing about 6 points from the firearms, so it's not the best, but if you are desperate, if you are looking for this mod, again, check out this vendor. And the final thing you guys want to look at is this extended magazine, and it actually comes with 117% magazine size, 3% critical hit chance, and 4% critical hit damage. It is missing about 4% in the magazine size, but I'm not really sure if you're missing a bullet actually or not. I don't think you are, so this one is a awesome pickup if you're missing a good magazine with both crit chance and critical hit damage. Once again, check out this vendor. Last but not least, you guys want to stop by the West 31st Shoot Checkpoint, and what you want to check out from him is this Omega Rifle Suppressor. Now what it comes with is 18% headshot damage, 4% critical hit damage, and 2.50% stability. Now, unfortunately, you are missing the critical hit chance, but if you are going for headshot damage, you're not really focusing that much, at least in my opinion, on critical hit chance. You just want the most headshot damage. And again, this one's not really that good, but if you are in desperate needs, if you don't want to buy the blueprints I showed you guys earlier, you just want to buy the attachments. Again, check out this vendor. It is being sold here. But yeah, that's going to be it for the video. Thank you all so much for watching. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. I respond to all my comments. But once again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.